Welcome to RaikoCool.com. In this video, we'll discuss about how to test Walmart or e-commerce related website. So generally, when I'm interacting with the software testers, I'm always seeing that or they are asking questions every time how to test any big applications. So e-commerce is a big platform where we are getting a maximum functionality to be covered. And if you can see here, plus website itself is having a lot of data for testing this and covering all the scenarios will be very much important. So we'll see here how to test Walmart website in detail. So if you're visiting this channel first time and you want to learn about software testing, please watch my complete software testing playlist. I will also include the URL in the description tab so that will be easy for you to refer. When any tester starting the software testing process of any e-commerce website, they should always have to focus on the major functionality first. So when they will start with the testing of the Walmart website, the logo is very much important part of any organizations. If there is any issues in logo or any differences found in between the logos, so that will create a negative impact in terms of user. So generally, this logo can be verified thoroughly and this logo should match with the branding team expectation. So here we have to do the comparisons and the color code as well as the when we click on the logo where it is navigating us. So you can see here it is navigating us into the next page where we can see the similar type of e-commerce website where we can see all the offers are listed here. Now next part will be a functionality part. So here the tester has to cover each and every session sections in detail. So let's say when we are clicking on the saving and feature swap, so it should navigate us to this page. And now here we can see there are lot many options are available. These are the filters. So when we click on this filter, we should get a filter or filtered objects available in our data. So in store, when I'm clicking on in store, so the item which is available in store should be visible for me. Now here we have the options of add to cart. So now when I will click on add, the first item will be added here. When I'm increasing and decreasing the number on clicking on this, that should be covered. Now, rather than going directly to the smaller sections, let's understand these all functionalities. So hovering options, when we'll hover, this window will appear, and when we click on this, it will navigate us to the next page. Next will be when we'll hover this main department sections, we should get this bar should be available and we can navigate it easily. When we'll click on shop now, that shop now page should open. So these all functionality we need to cover in department sections, and every section is important. So they should not have any dead end of the websites or any navigation with not working, which is a negative impact creation at the in the mind of user. So here we have gift cards. Once we'll click on gift card, it will navigate us to gift card page, where we can see all these gift card options should be available. This section is for the address. So this is totally available when we have the account or when we logged in with the account. If we don't logged in with the account or we are just watching or viewing the content of this website, then this address should not be available. Groceries, so here we have subsections where once we'll click on these sections, it should navigate us to the respective pages. Now we have my items. Once we'll click on the my items, it should navigate us to the my items page. Then we have fashions or different other categories are available. And after clicking on this, we are again getting a sub menus or sub categories. So here in the left panel, we have the categories of gender related, like women's, women's plus, men, girls, and boys. So these are the differentiations which we are getting in the age or the gender related specific contents. So once anyone wants to view like boys. So once they click on the new arrivals, it should navigate us to the new arrival page. And now here we have very important sections. This image is very important. So this image should be clearly visible. We have the options. Now we should be able to see the price sections. And after that, we are expecting to have some detail. So these are the smaller details which users wants to view it. So this is the product related informations are available. Now we have pickup, delivery, and 3+ day shipping details. So these all details should be available in page. Now, if anyone is searching into particular sections, so that should navigate into the main board. Now, here we have the options like reorder. So in my items, we can see three options are available, and whenever the customer will click on these options, it should navigate us to the main page. Then we have sign in account, and after that we have the cart sections, and in the bottom section we have this footer. So this footer is also very important. That should work perfectly fine. Then we have copyright message. So these items should be covered. And if any customer wants to get the feedback, which is very valuable for the any brands, so that should navigate into the feedback page. And here we can share their feedback. One starting with the very poor and five will be excellent. So these navigation should work perfectly fine. And apart of that, this is only as a part of functionality testing, which we are doing. And normally, if we don't have the test cases, we can do as a ad hoc testing. But what if we have to verify this into any other browser? Simply copy this and open into Microsoft Edge or any other browser, click on that and see the differences. So the details which is available on Google Chrome, that exactly same details should be available into Microsoft Edge and similar to the Firefox or Internet Explorer, any of the browsers. So this is called as compatibility testing in between the browser. So if every browser is showing exactly similar type of content, it means this website is perfectly fine in all the browsers. Now, after that, the tester has to verify the loading time, how much time it is taking for loading any particular content, and when they are paying the details, or then when they are making the payment, that should also be in the encrypted format, like at the time of entering the credit card detail or a payment details, that should be asterisk mark, and that should not ask the any additional details apart of the required things like CVV detail or any other details. So these all require at the time of making payment. But if any additional details will be asked by the website, the user will not prefer to visit this website again and again. That should taken care. So this is how we are verifying or testing Walmart website or any commerce e-commerce related website in detail. So that's all about this video. You have enjoyed this content. If you think so, this will be useful, don't forget to share within your circle. Thank you for watching.